Hello and welcome to another Whiteboard Wednesday training. I am Isaiah Henkel, a Cheeky Scientist, and today I want to talk to you about five trending career options in industry, so five industry jobs that are hot right now, specifically for postdocs. Now, of course, if you have a PhD and you're in a postdoc or maybe you're unemployed, these positions would apply to you, but I do want to talk to postdocs right now because the average length of a postdoc has extended dramatically over the last few years. You used to be able to do a postdoc for 1 or 2 years tops and get into a professorship position. Now the average is 6 to 10 years. And this is usually broken up over multiple different postdoc appointments, 2 or 3 on average, right? And we know how this works. You've likely been a part of this. It's called chasing postdocs. You get a postdoc appointment, it ends, you leave, go to another university for another postdoc, it ends, you leave, you go to another university for another postdoc, and then the university, maybe a different university or the same university, will hire you as a research associate or a staff scientist, but really you're just a postdoc. They change the name because they don't want it to look bad that you've been doing a postdoc for 10 years. So if you're in that position, maybe you've started looking at industry jobs, you're wondering what else is out there. If you're like most postdocs, you know that there are jobs in industry and there are jobs in academia. For jobs in industry, it's a black box. Maybe you know that you can work at the bench or work away from the bench, but that's about it. Maybe you've heard some job titles floating around like a principal scientist, etc., the ones that are similar to what you're doing in academia. But there's a lot of other job options out there where the employers for these jobs are specifically looking for PhDs and where you are very, very valuable. Your PhD experience, certainly your postdoc experience, can be leveraged to get into these trending positions that will pay you very well for doing meaningful work. Now, what do I mean by trending? I mean, just in the last few months, we've seen hiring way up for these five jobs, okay? Now, some of them have a longer trend. Some of them, the hiring has been up for the last couple of years. But specifically, we're looking for the jobs that are hot right now, that you should start looking at right now if you're trying to get hired in industry. Number one, data scientist. Okay, there's a misconception that you have to be an engineer to get into a data scientist position, or that you even have to know a certain programming language, like Python, whatever else. You don't. There are data scientist positions out there for life scientists, for physical scientists, right? Certainly for engineers, of course. And there are data scientist positions that don't require programming. This term, it's much more of an umbrella term now. But if you start looking at data scientists, you will be able to find positions for you no matter what your background is. This position is up well over 100%, and you can look at recent mass bio reports that show data on how many PhDs are being hired into these roles, well over 100% increase. There's also an over 100% increase in the number of PhDs being hired for medical science liaison positions. That liaison word is important. It means that you're going to be liaising with a lot of people in the field. So a company's clients, usually they are MDs. If you're working for a large pharmaceutical company, for example, a new drug might be coming out. You're going to be working with MDs, PhDs, other key opinion leaders, KOLs, right? And you're going to be sharing information with them. They share information back with you that you would share with your company. It's not a sales position. In fact, you can't sell in that position. It's a great position for a lot of PhDs. Again, no matter what your background is, there's a misconception where PhDs think that they have to have experience, clinical experience, they have to have experience with drug pathways to get into these positions. We see people without any of that experience transitioning into medical science liaison roles. Typically MDs and PharmDs in the past were hired into these roles. Now PhDs are hired more often than MDs or PharmDs. Number three, regulatory affairs. This is a phrase that was not used very much at all even 10 years ago, certainly not in terms of hiring PhDs. It's a very hot field. It's, again, an umbrella term that can mean a lot of things. It has to do with the development of a product, of a treatment, of the regulation side of things. So getting it to market legally, right? So it could have to do with organizing things in terms of a patent for a new product. It could have to do with making sure that the IP is sound, making sure that you're not breaking any laws, right, when you take a product to market. If you want to get more experience in this area, you can go down to your university's local tech transfer office. You can talk to them about it. Get used to the regulatory side of things. It's a very hot field right now. And very likely, if you have experience in science, in a lab, there's something regulatory-wise going on that you may not know about. Learn about it, and you can gain some of the transferable skills relevant for these positions. Number four, medical writing. Okay, medical writing is a phrase that has to do with 6, 7, 8 different types of positions. It could be scientific writing. It could be pure medical on-label writing, where you're actually writing the things that go on a label for a new drug that's coming out. It could be something where you're working with a company for over-the-counter products only. There's a lot of different types of medical writing positions, but it's a field that PhDs are being hired more and more for because marketing, communications, all of this stuff becomes crucially important. In fact, some people define this field as scientific communications or medical communications, but as a scientist, you can write at a much higher level, or as an engineer, as a PhD, as a postdoc, certainly, you're very valuable for these positions, and often you can do them from home if that's something that interests you. Last but not least, clinical affairs or medical affairs. These terms are sometimes used interchangeably. Sometimes they mean the same thing, sometimes they mean something different. I want to really just focus on clinical positions overall, right? Clinical affairs, clinical project management. These positions are very hot for PhDs right now. Again, it's a field where usually before in the past, the 1980s, 1990s, you would need clinical experience to get into them. You don't now. They know that PhDs are experts at learning. Most of the PhDs we see transition into clinical affairs roles, into clinical project management, medical affairs, have no clinical experience whatsoever. It's a misconception. You do not need clinical experience to get into a clinical job, so don't count yourself out. A couple of things I want you to keep in mind. CROs, right? This is my nice little pie chart. This is just showing that more jobs are open for PhDs and CROs now than pharmaceutical companies. Pharmaceutical companies are hiring PhDs at an accelerated rate. However, CROs, contract research organizations, not to be confused with just clinical research organizations, but contract research organizations, companies that specialize in something. They might specialize in a technology like flow cytometry. And larger pharmaceutical companies will hire a CRO to do all of their flow cytometry experiments. PhDs are being hired into CROs and being paid very, very well. More PhDs are hired into CRO positions than pharmaceutical positions. What is a key skill you can focus on to increase your chances of getting hired at any of these positions? Project management. There's a lot of reports, especially there's a Dow Chemical report that showed that more than anything else, industry employers want to know that you as a PhD have project management experience. Now you're probably managing multiple projects right now. It's a little bit different in industry because you have to focus on deliverables, budgets, and timelines, okay? You likely have experience with this in the lab, you just don't know how to speak about it in terms of the industry language or the industry nomenclature. Use those words. Deliverables, right? A deliverable that you're working on right now could just be a subset of data, okay? You're doing an experiment, you're managing a project to get the data. The data is the deliverable for you. In industry, it might be something more tangible. Okay, timelines, you have to get those experiments done at a certain time to use the data for a grant. Okay, timelines matter, so speak about timelines. Finally, budgets. You have a budget in the lab, right? Reagents cost money, you can speak about budgets. Use all of these things to talk about your project management experience when you are applying for any of these top trending positions. Hopefully this helps you. If you have any questions on any of these careers, please let me know in the comments section on this post. Please tell me which one of these 5 trending careers you are most interested in. I'd love to hear from you. If you want to get more information about these careers and get access to all of our free materials, just go to PhDsGetHired.com. PhDsGetHired.com. I'll see you next week with another teaching point, with another Whiteboard Wednesday training video that we do on Wednesdays only. Until next time, remember your value as a PhD and start thinking and acting like a successful industry professional.